Welcome back. Stepping into the lithographs museum at the Bibliotheca Alexandrina is like a journey back in time. Dina Yunus met the director of the museum, Dr. Yusuf Zidane, who recently received a prestigious award. He is going to tell her about all about it in the next interview that we're going to watch together.
Today we have with us the novelist Dr. Yusuf Zidane, who is also the director of the Manuscript Museum in Alexandria Bibliotheca. His novel Azazil won the Best Arabian Novel in 2009. Azazil is one of Satan's name, and it's only his second novel. So welcome, Dr. Yusuf, and please shed some light on that prize and also on yourself.
The Arabic Booker Prize is one of the biggest prizes in literature, Arabic literature, and it's a branch of the famous Booker British Prize in England, and this prize has two branches. A Russian one and the Arabic one. It started 2007, and the first winner was Baha Tahir, he's Egyptian novelist, and I was the second. And the third one, this year in fact, he was from Saudi Arabia, Abdu Khel, because he won by his novel Termi Bisharag, it means it sent some fire or something. It was a good novel anyway. In my time, my
when you got the prize,
yes. It was a big competition between maybe 130.
Oh.
Yes, and according to the procedures of the Booker prize, they make a short, a long list for 16 novels, and then short list, 6 novels, and then the winner they do it in a great festival in Abu Dhabi. It was a very nice moment, especially my novel.
Yes.
Made some...
It was controversial, actually, in Egypt.
In fact, it was a novel attacked by some people, yes, who want the Egyptians, especially the Egyptians,
yes,
stay as an ignorant people.
Okay.
They considered that my novel against Christianity, but day by day, people here and there, they realized that it's not true. And many indications now we have, for example, the great success of the novel in the Italian translation.
Okay.
And many other languages, and many of bishops in another churches.
Okay.
They wrote very positive yes, ideas about Azazil, because it's against violence. It's not against
exactly
a specific charge or specific people, but it's against violence.
Yeah.
And against this attitude which use religion to make...
As an excuse.
Yes.
Okay. So have your historical studies helped you in writing the details of the book, or is it your personal culture and experience?
Both, in fact, because no one can write a novel about the beginning of the 5th century without a wide and big knowledge about this time, especially the Heba the monk, the main character,
yes,
in my novel. He was a physician and monk, and He moved from Upper Egypt to Alexandria to Palestine to Aleppo. So it's a big area and critical era also.
Dr. Yusuf, how long it took you to write your second winner novel?
It takes maybe 1 year, but of course with a long time of research and
preparation
and rebuild the ideas. Okay. It takes a long time, of course, because in this time with the ancient knowledge in medicine, for example, it was my field originally.
Okay.
So I used my my knowledge, my information, my reflections to put it inside the novel and to come deep enough.
And it seems that you have a great knowledge also about the monk's life inside monasteries.
Yes.
Which is basically an Egyptian idea.
Yes. Sure, but there is another idea right now about the monks in Syria and Turkey. They started this attitude the same time.
So what's the general theme of your next novel, or would you like to leave it as a surprise?
No, it's not a surprise. It will be published this month.
This month?
Yes.
Okay.
It's entitled The Napatean. It's about Napateans, some group of the Arabs.
Yes.
They came with the Arabic and Islamic conqueror, Amr ibn al-As.
Yes.
And they helped Egyptian and Arabs to live together.
I see.
But the novel is about a young lady, 18 years old.
Okay.
She is married by a merchant from Nabatean, and she moved from Delta of the Nile through Sinai, of course, and then she lived in Jordan.
Okay.
At that time, yes, near Petra, the historical place.
Yes.
And she was an eyewitness of this preparation of the Muslim and Arabs coming to Egypt.
Yeah, it's a very interesting period, which lots of people have no idea about, because it's very rare and there aren't much books that were written about the Nabataeans.
Especially, there is, from my point of view, there is a lot of illusions about this time also. And our historical studies still
are not sufficient.
A part of the reality of this, time and this action.
Okay.
I'm trying in my novel to give another perspective, another dimension, as a point of view. I hope it will be lucky.
Okay. Dr. Yusuf, thank you so much for being with us, and best of luck in your next novel.
Thank you.
You're welcome.